What would you do if you needed to communicate with a deaf person who also cannot read? What if you did not know sign language either? Around 60 years ago, in a small farming village named Sadat Tawaher, there lived a man named Hanash. See him on the left? Hanash, like everyone else, was born hearing and learned Arabic as his mother tongue. However, in his early 20s, Hanash lost his hearing completely to become the first deaf person in Sadat Tawaher. He became deaf, he became sick for a few days, and then his hearing was gone forever. He had no difficulty at all communicating with others because he had acquired his native language, Arabic. But no one knew how to communicate with him. Since he could not hear anymore, people did not know how to communicate with him for the first deaf person. So the tiny town of Sadat Tawaher, of only 300 people, had a deaf person for the first time. Now, Hanash had not gone to school and therefore had no reading or writing literacy. So communicating with him through writing was not an option for his family or friends. On the other hand, no one in Sadat Tawaher, including, most importantly, his friends and family, had any access to or knowledge of sign language. Nor did they have any access to deaf education, nor were there any deaf schools in the area for his family and friends to go and learn sign language. So what would you do in that situation, ask yourself? So using sign language was not an available alternative either for anyone in that town. So Hanesh's family embarks on a journey of finding a solution for the challenge that they were faced with for the first time. Now, if you thought in the scenario that I presented to you at the beginning of my talk, if you thought of gestures as a solution, that's exactly what Hanesh's family also came up with. So communication through gestures is an everyday task. We use gestures on a daily basis. We call them co-speech gestures. Co-speech gestures. In fact, according to Zwichinski and Wasowicz 2019, language probably emerged as gesture first. That probably explains even why chimpanzees, our closest cousins, are so good. They're excellent at learning signs and even creating sentences, although very simple sentences. Millions of years of evolution have equipped us with cognitive capabilities and mechanisms that eventually paved the way for the emergence of language in the modern sense. One question regarding Hanesh's family's communication system is it a language? In other words, is it likely that these gestures have, over time, have become a language? Now, I want to make the bold claim that it is a language. Now, calling Hanesh's gestural system a language might sound like too big of a claim, but in order to substantiate my claim, let's see what language is. Cambridge Dictionary defines a language as a system of communication consisting of sounds, words, and grammar. Now, a sign language is one in which the medium of communication is not speech or sounds, but signs. So the modality of communication is not speech or auditory, but gestural and visual, right? So what do you need to have a language? You need words, and you need rules to put those words together to create sentences in order to communicate thoughts, ideas, feelings, and concepts, right? And Hanesh's family's gesture system has those exact components. It has signs representing words, and it has rules that string those signs together to create sentences. So they have nouns like ball, plane, bread. They have verbs like rain, see, hear, sit, stand, sleep. They also have pronouns like I, you, he, she, they, and if you like it, y'all. Now, some signs are iconic, meaning that you probably can guess what they mean from the handshape. Rain, see, hear. Some signs are less iconic, meaning that it's hard to tell what they mean. This is marriage. Now, some signs also have acquired, over time, have acquired metaphorical meanings. The sign for sleep also means to die, sleeping forever. Now, you can also play around with signs to create new meanings. This is the sign for male, and this is a boy. And this is a man, playing by playing with height, right? Now, so you can create meanings like man harvesting. Some signs also have changed over time. So the sign for harvest, just like spoken language, has changed for over time. So the sign for harvest was this, which is the sign that represents sickle. However, 20 years ago, the tiny town of Sadat Tawaher started using combines to harvest. Can you guess what the sign is for harvest today? It's this sign, right? Now, so you can create sentences. Now, Hanash's families follow a very strict order to create sentences, subjects first and then verbs. So you can say, man, harvest. The man is harvesting. Now, it turns out that being able to create sentences alone is not enough. So if I sign the sentence, friend, eat chicken, it is hard to tell, does this sentence mean my friend ate chicken or my friend will eat chicken? Which one? So what is missing? What's missing is time, or to borrow a technical term from linguistics, you need tense. Tense indicates when something happened or will happen. Now, research by cognitive scientists such as George Lakoff and Mark Johnson and others has indicated that human beings tend to think of time as a line. That's why we have the word timeline. With the past located behind you, the present immediately in front of you, and the future ahead of you. That's why in English we have words, for instance, in English, words like last and next refer to not only physical entities like last stop, next station, but also last week and next month, temporal entities. Now, this is how Hanish's family signed, my friend ate chicken. Friend ate chicken. And this is how they signed, my friend will eat chicken. So, quite surprisingly, Hanish's family's gestural system, which probably they're just simply as gestures, has now developed to possess all the characteristics of a fully-fledged language, one which is capable of fulfilling any linguistic function that any other language, like Japanese or French or American Sign Language, can achieve. Now, at this point, you might be wondering how I know all these things about Hanash and his family. I do because Hanash is my father. And like my other 8 siblings, that's a lot of siblings, I grew up signing to him a language that emerged naturally in my family over 6 decades. Over 6 decades, my family's sign language has proven extremely effective in enabling us to communicate with my father. We can, using our sign language, we can greet him, we can ask questions, we can show agreement, we can show disagreement, we can talk about hypothetical situations, we can tell lies, we can tell jokes and stories. We can even pray, amongst many other functions. Let me re-emphasize, if you can do all of these things, it's not just a bunch of gestures. Now, you might be asking, who has acquired this language? Since my father's hearing loss 6 decades ago, a few generations have acquired this sign language. On the left, you see some of, the far left, you can see my father and some of his close friends. The first generation who learned this sign language must have been his own generation, that is, his parents and siblings and neighbors and close friends. They must have been the group who initiated signing to him after he became deaf. The second generation is his own children, 9 children, who acquired this language as their native language, although they were all hearing, and therefore learned Arabic as their mother tongue, as their spoken mother tongue. His children grew up signing and speaking at the same time. So they grew up with 2 different modalities, the spoken modality and the signing modality. And the third generation, the last generation to learn this language, were my father's and his friend's grandchildren. They learned this as either their native language or as a second language. Now, can everybody sign fluently, you might ask? Well, if you have ever stayed abroad for a while, you might have noticed that the closer people are to you, the more they learn about you and your language and your culture. The same also applies to my family's sign language. His children, my father's children, can know this language very well and can sign very fluently and fast, and others know this to a lesser extent. The closer people are to my father, the better they know how to sign. His children know very well how to sign, others to a lesser extent. acquaintances can barely sign at all. And in cases where there is a person who doesn't know the sign language and needs to communicate with my father, someone will have to translate for that person. So it's a completely different language if you have to translate. Now, every time I tell the story of my family's sign language to almost anyone, one frequent question that I get out of many is this. Did your family consciously create this sign language, or did it naturally emerge? Where did it come from? Now, the answer, in my opinion, is not either or, but both. So you see, clearly, my father's family and friends had tried to communicate with him because they needed to, because he could not hear anymore. The sign language thus emerged out of this natural need and desire to communicate with a deaf person, which was also driven by their conscious efforts to communicate with a deaf individual. And therefore, my father, this sign language emerged out of the natural need and desire for communication and the conscious efforts at the same time. So the answer, in my opinion, is not either or, but both. And on the other hand, my father was by no means socially isolated, unlike many other communities. And his deafness was not stigmatized at all. In fact, quite the opposite. In the close-knit Arab society, older people are held to high regard. And my father was one of the elders who interacted with many people on a daily basis. Many people would not even know that he was deaf unless they communicated with him and he would not respond. That's how involved in the society he was. Another frequent question I get is this. Is this language, is it the same as Arabic? In other words, do your family sign the same language that they speak, which is Arabic? Do they share the same grammar? That's basically the question. Now, logically, one would predict and expect that this language should be based, the grammar of the sign language should be based on the grammar of the language that everyone already knows, right, which is Arabic. It makes sense, because why create a language with a new grammar when you can simply sign the spoken language? Now, before I reveal the answer, that makes perfect sense, right? And it sounds quite reasonable. Now, before I reveal the answer to you, let me mention that since the start of my PhD in 2018 in linguistics at Purdue, I have conducted 7 or 8 projects on different areas of the grammar of our family's sign language. My projects have been on word order, declarative sentences, negative sentences, question forms, conditional sentences, and relative clauses. My purpose has been to compare the sign language with Arabic to find out if they share and they use the same grammar. If they don't, then that means they are two different languages. I also presented the results of all these projects as a keynote speech at the University of Edinburgh in Scotland last year. Now, the answer is probably not what most of you expect. Although my family all speak Arabic as our native language, we sign a different language. We sign a different grammar. Our sign language is quite different from Arabic. In other words, my father's family and friends, in their attempts to communicate with my father, had created a new grammar, and therefore a new language. Now, it is possible, and I believe it's also plausible to argue, that because of the nature of the visual modality of sign language, a different and new grammar was preferred and deemed more effective in conveying messages than the grammar of the spoken language, Arabic. Now, there's more to the story of our sign language. It is surprisingly similar, despite having no contact whatsoever with other fully developed languages. We see that it is surprisingly similar to other fully-fledged sign languages, such as American Sign Language, Indo-Pakistani, Turkish, and Greek sign languages. For instance, in our sign language, in order to indicate that a sentence is a question, we raise our eyebrows. Is it raining? And to indicate that it is not a question, in order to indicate that it's a negative sentence, we move the dominant hand and the head, and we shake our heads side to side at the same time, simultaneously. Now, it turns out the brow raise and side-to-side head shake are only two examples of a large number of facial expressions and body and head movements that turn out to be ubiquitously, if not universally, shared among other sign languages. It is Plato who is believed to have famously written, "Our need will be the real creator." Hanash's story is inspiring. It demonstrates that language necessity is the mother of invention. It is the story of language emergence and development without the aid of technology, education, or even literacy. Language is a cooperative collective endeavor driven by human biology and social interaction. Just like how species might evolve in any direction to better fit their environment in order to survive, our sign language also evolved to make it possible to communicate with a deaf person. Although no one had previously created such a thing in my hometown, simply because they had not needed to. Perhaps more importantly, on a higher level, it demonstrates that language is a truly human phenomenon. It's a phenomenon that goes beyond race or ethnicity or culture or language. It goes beyond any of these boundaries. It is not bound by any, but beyond any of these factors. It is the glue that binds us together as the human race. We are much more similar than we think. On December 27th, 2021, my father passed away. Upon his death, he was the only deaf person in Sadat Tawaher. And with him gone, it's only a matter of time before our sign language disappears. A language that is not used will not survive. However, his legacy is here, hopefully, to stay with us. In honor of my father and his family and friends, I am conducting my PhD dissertation on my family's sign language. Thank you.